Welcome. We have an ASUS. Now this ASUS has been to another tech and apparently it needs a new motherboard. It's quite a high end, 10th gen i7. And they could be right. They could be right that it needs a new motherboard. Let's do our own diagnostics and let's see what we can do for the client. Okay, 1 second. All right, so the machine had to be rebooted. Let's have a look. We've got multimeter and DC mode. Check the charger first. The charger is happy. Connect the charger. We should get a white or a yellow light. Nothing. Okay, now we've connected that. Let's see if the DC jack went into protection mode. No, it didn't. So I was expecting a possibly shorted main DC jack, but it is not the case at the moment. Let's see if we can help this job. Our only hope is that it has not been further damaged. So it has been open to a certain degree. Okay, let's go ahead and do our own diagnostics. All right. That one is different. What is this liquid? There's so much moisture-like material. Okay, so let's have a look what the issue potentially could be. Resistance mode. That's the shunt resistor. Dead short on the 19 volt rail. Highly unusual. Something blew up. Okay, so let's isolate this shunt resistor. So we can find out which side has a short. Well, this is unfortunate. The short is on the system side, so the main DC and MOSFETs are fine. Okay, this is not good. So that area has been worked on. We can see these guys have been repositioned. This is not a factory installation. Let's see which side the short is now on. Let's check the CPU side first. That's a dead short. So 19 volts has gone straight into the CPU. Anything else obvious? Interesting, why did this problem happen? This is not factory thermal paste either. Is this liquid conductive? SRGKW. This is the other side, looking for anything obvious. All right, so we have a dead CPU. Let's check the cable resistance. Yeah, see that's cable resistance. Click on relative and now click on here. Okay, and here. What is the resistance of the shunt resistor? now. We might have a chance. Or am I dreaming? Okay. Well, only way to find out, right? Let's see what it takes at 1 volt injection. What happens at 1 volt? How did you become upside down? There we go. So we have 1 volt on the line. Our ground is good. Okay, so whatever that is, we should be able to detect on the thermal camera. I think it's going to be the CPU, eh? It's a high-end CPU, so I'm just praying that we might have a chance. Okay, now it's really hard to inject power at this angle. Okay. All right, let's see if anything goes anywhere. Yeah, it is the CPU. See that red dot over here? Now I'm gonna remove my hand. Short is gone. Put it back. Thank you. Will there be something obvious around here? A reflection. Okay. Yeah, so we have to go with the CPU at the moment. CPU is definitely warming up. Okay. This is a dead CPU. So what do we do now? That's the end of this guy. We do have a replacement board, which is i5 version. We'll give them the option of the downgrade, but on this guy, resistance of the CPU should be 3.72 ohms. So resistance to ground. Cable resistance with the relative option 0.29, so it's about 3.3 ohms. Okay, we'll leave it at that. Let's see what they want to do. So thanks for watching, see you in the next one.
Thanks for watching, please subscribe to support this channel.